the 30th of April 1943, RAF Elvington, Yorkshire, England. The crew of Halifax JB803 prepare for a mission to Essen, Germany. The crews listen very carefully. Important mission details are written down. Information on fighters, weather and route are given. After briefing, the crews will go to their airplane. The pilot and flight engineer prepare the airplane for takeoff. Together, they will perform the pre-flight checks. Halifax has a crew of 7. A bomb aimer. A navigator. A pilot. A flight engineer. A wireless operator. A mid upper gunner and a rear gunner. Around midnight, the crew and the airplane are ready to take off into the dark night. Together as a team. Everyone depends on one another. After they drop their bombs, it is time to go back to England. The mission was a success. When they fly above Holland, they are picked up by German radar. At this point, JB803 is at 6,300 meters. Heinz Winkler is guided to JB803. Winkler attacks from the back of the Halifax, damaging it severely. The Halifax is no longer able to stay airborne and loses altitude quickly. When above Moden, most of the crew bail out. The pilot and the gunner are still in the airplane. An attempted landing fails. The pilot, Watson, has circled above Moden for 20 minutes, hoping that the crew has a chance of safely escaping certain death. Unfortunately, the crew bailed out over the Eidsulmir. 5 crewmen drown in the ice-cold water. Watson is killed in the crash. The tail gunner, Scarf, was probably already killed or wounded by Winkler. Both were found outside the wreckage and buried the same day. The other crewmen washed ashore in the following days. Loud is still missing. Ian Douglas Crawford, flight engineer. Raymond Shepherd, mid-upper gunner. Leon Hennan, bomb aimer. Thomas Dual Scarf, rear gunner. Gordon Watson, pilot. Arthur Edward Parsons, navigator. William Robert Loud. Arthur Edward Parsons, Gordon Watson, Thomas Dual Scarf, they shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. But the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.